my battery.
Sorry. I am security here.
Security. Yeah.
Well, why we're here today again, because we're going to delay this project. All right.
Until
we kill it. That's right. And we call this the Titanic mess on South Van Ness. And you know what the Titanic was for, right? All those luxury, you know, boats, right? And that's what this is about. Titanic luxury development for rich people. And that's why we're here as a coalition of residents, businesses, nonprofits, the faith community, and everybody who's opposing this development. They want to build 165 luxury rental units.
No!
You know how much those rental units go for, right?
Too much.
That's it, exactly. And they're only proposing to build 12% affordable units.
Affordable for who?
Low market, not affordable.
So there's some of us who were involved in the struggle and the fight in the Bayview, Hunters Point, and Treasure Island. So let me tell you a little bit about Lennar for those of you who don't know who Lennar is. Okay? Let me just tell you a little bit about it. And this is an updated version. Okay? In the Bayview, they got a land grab giveaway of 100 acres. And it's a land grab giveaway. They're proposing to build 12,000 new homes. They also recently got the old Candlestick Park site where they're going to build a shopping mall. They're also now going to build 3 million square feet of offices for the tech industry. They're going to build a private school for K-12. Exactly. In the Bayview. A private school. They're spending, as of today, $8 billion in the Bayview. Now let's go to Treasure Island. They got 465 acres land grab giveaway by the city of San Francisco. And they're proposing to build 8,000 units and retail space. So why would they want to come to the mission to build 160 units? Does that make sense? Exactly. Really. Do they need business?
No.
Do they need business?
No.
All right. So I want to bring Eddie up here. Come on. Come here, Eddie. You know, Eddie is the neighbor that lives right down the street. And you know, Eddie has, when we started organizing on this, Eddie took the lead, you know, as a neighbor here. And I just give a big round of applause to Eddie for all the work that he's been doing organizing the neighbors. Because that's what it's about. It's about neighbors organizing neighbors, going door to door and informing, educating, and letting people know and empowering our neighbors of what the hell is going on by these big developers. Thank you, Eddie. So let me introduce my good brother from another mother who's become my brother in this fight for the last 3.5 years, and we both grew up here in this barrio. Eric Arguello, who's the president of Calle 24 Latino Cultural District.
Thank you, Roberto.
And yes, we do have a big family. Good morning. My name is Eric Arguello. I'm co-founder and president of the Calle 24 Latino Customs District. And today we're asking Lennar to gift this property to the city for 100% affordable housing. Yeah. Mayor Lee, in collaboration with the San Francisco Latino Historical Society and San Francisco Heritage, to establish the Calle 24 Latino Cultural District. This resolution passed with a unanimous vote by the San Francisco Board of Supervisors. The spirit and intent of the resolution was to acknowledge the history, work, and contributions of the Latino community in the district and San Francisco. This began a community process as to how the Calle 24 LCD would best serve the community. After months of reaching out to thousands of community members, public meetings, focus groups, and stakeholder interviews, the top priority for a resident was affordable housing and the concern around gentrification, high rents for tenants and businesses, and the area causing mass displacement, loss of cultural assets, and mission culture. This helps us establish our mission, goals, and priorities. And some of those priorities are to strengthen, preserve, and enhance Latino arts, cultural institutions, enterprises, activities, encourage economic vitality and economic justice for district families, working people, and immigrants, promote economic sustainability for neighborhood businesses and nonprofits, preserve and create stable, genuine, affordable, and low-income housing in the district and related infrastructure, manage and establish guidelines for development and economic change in ways that preserve the district, Latino community, and cultures. And last, foster a sustainable local economy that provides vital goods and services to the district. So as we continue to develop our land use policies and the creation of our special use district that will give us teeth and protect us for the future, high-end developments like Lennar's do not meet the community needs or goals of the LCD, but will bring the demand for high-end goods and services, cause an increase in rent for our mom-and-pop businesses, replacing them with investor-type businesses, and increasing rents for our residents, causing the destruction of our local and cultural economy that creates the Calle 24 Latino Cultural District and the Mission District. Lennar is not a fit in the LCD or the Mission District. No, say no not. To Lennar. No. Si se puede. Gracias. Se puede. Si se puede. Se puede. Se puede.
Thank you, Brother Eric. Next, we have another brother from La Mission, long-time resident, activist, been involved with labor for many years with the Carpenters Union. Please give it up for Jim Salinas.
Good morning, brother. Good morning, brother. First of all, I was asked to step in here only because I have been an executive officer of the Carpenters Union for 3 decades, served on the San Francisco Building and Construction Trades Council as a delegate for 3 decades as well. So I can tell you very well that I've never seen anything like this, but I just want to, first of all, before I say that, I want to commend the brothers from Laborers Local 261 for having drafted the resolution. Council supporting this community. So now president in act I've not never seen. But as well with building the community that they have always said that they are part of, that we are a part of, that labor is a part of. Because many of our brothers and sisters grew up here, lived here, obviously rented homes here, and now are finding themselves displaced in the East Bay as far as Modesto and Manteca, when they want to live here. So I just want to, again, commend the brothers and sisters that are here, because actually, folks, said just a ragtag group of folks. Don't worry. You know, people like Nick Fidel say, don't worry. And thankfully, I am a member of the Carpenters Union. I'm very proud. Unfortunately, some of our people from the East Bay have come in here and tried to sway things so that Nick Fidel, his contractor, Bill Group, which is the contractor that came in, promised the community jobs, none of which ever materialized. So these are people that we can trust. It's about money over people. But today, the people have said that's not the way it's going to go down here. So I want to commend each and every one of you. I want to commend the leaders, Loretto Hernandez, certainly Eric as well, and again the labor for having taken on a very difficult and impossible task, what I thought not going to happen, but they did it. So want to commend you once again, and the fight is on. We continue. Thank you very much, all of you.
Thank you, Jeff. And I want to bring up my Nicoya sister, Annabelle Bolanos, who's a resident right here, who's also stepped on and is part of this fight to stop Lennar.
Hola, and deja vu. We were here, I don't recall how long ago. But here we are. And, you know, I was coming here and I was reading the news, and it's everywhere that a 99-year-old woman is fighting addiction.
Yeah.
And it's shocking. To me, the shock itself is shocking because she's not the first. She's not the only one. She's not the last one. So it appears to me that artificial intelligence has also taken over morals. Because there is just this, I don't know. I was reading about the man that's evicting her and how he is in charge of housing policy in the town he lives in. It's just a clusterfuck. It's crazy. And I live half a block away from here, so this would greatly, greatly impact my quality of life. I know that every day there are day laborers that stand here, sit here. I know that we have houseless folks that hang out around here. I was just talking to the liquor store owner about the impact of it, and he was like, oh, not affordable? No, no, no. So, there's a lot of money. It's a big wave of money, but we, the people, we have to make enough noise. We have to scream. We have to kick. We have to do whatever we have to do and try to stop these people. They have a track record. We know who they are. We know who they are. We just had a full report on them, and we just can't allow this. If we allow this titanic mess on South and End, then it's unstoppable. The floodgates have opened, and it'll be harder to close them. So, la lucha sigue.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, and that's from Green Action and from the Bay U. It's here for the Bay U. In the house, Marie, give it up.
Hi, like you said, my name is Marie Harrison, and I hail from the Baby Hunters Point. And I say Baby Hunters Point because they've been trying to separate babies from Hunters Point for a while. So let me start off by saying to the ladies in the house, you'll understand that we've already drawn a line in the sand. Did you notice? I have no heels on. I say that I'm taking off my heels, and I think most of you will understand. For the gentlemen in the audience, that means we're ready to do battle. Okay? So I came to fight. I'm sorry. If you're not willing to get down, then slide out of the way. No disrespect, but I'm ready to fight. Because you know what? My family can't afford to live in Bayview Hunters Point. In Bayview, affordable housing is a dirty word, because when a one-bedroom rent for $3,500 a month, and the average income is not even $35,000 a year. Excuse me. You know what? I'm ready to fight. But you the hell out of me. How are we supposed to survive? We can't do this. We actually have taken the stance that we will not sit silently by and watch this happen, not only in the Mission. By the way, my family and I used to live on 24th Street, right on the corner of South Bend. So, and 24th Street is actually my home as well. So if you ain't mad about it, I am. And I got enough anger build up for all of us. So either get behind me, get beside me, but please don't get in front of me because I'm wrong. I have had it. And I don't even want to start talking about Lennar because I burned your ears up, because these folks are like a plague of locusts that have swept their way through our Golden Gate Bridge. Like, you know what locusts do. All of you know the history. This is what Lennar has become to us, a plague of locusts. And we need to stop it. And spraying insect and repelling ain't going to make it. We've got to get down and dirty, get the fires out, and burn them. Ooh-wee! I'm trying to be a lady right here. Most of y'all don't know. And I swear that my mother is rolling over going, girl, where did you learn those words? But damn, I'm tired of this shit. Excuse me. I can't take it. If they don't stop, behind me, but baby, please don't get in front of me because I'm rolling. Right. Thank you.
How you like that?
I love you. See, that's what we need. We need some troopers.
She's been fighting Lennar for, what, 20 years?
Hey. Yeah, older than I am.
All right, now, you know, it takes artists, just like takes businesses, like Eric and residents, you know, and Jackie Varshak has been with the Cultural Art Arts Network, CAN. They've been supporting.
And Lee's re-election campaign. They've also given thousands of dollars to the Democratic Central Committee.
Yes.
And to the California Building Industry Association, PAC, the Political Action Committee. So we know how they get their way to destroy a perfectly good building that could be used for businesses or services that would help the residents of the Mission. We don't need luxury housing. Luxury housing creates a gentrification equals police brutality. There is a reason that there have been 3 shootings in just this neighborhood in the last 2 years. That we want Lennar to actually transfer this building to the mayor's office on housing for eventual community control so that we can build affordable housing. And in combination with the senior housing that is being planned, the 100% low-income senior housing project just behind here that could service people in this neighborhood. And lastly, Lennar really needs, if they do this, they need to do it right, or the planning department should not approve this project. And I want to urge people to come out when this goes before the planning commissioners and speak in public comment that Lennar has not conducted an environmental impact review. This is essential so that we know what the impact is going to be on traffic and on the economic effects of having a luxury development at this site. So we urge the Planning Commission to vote no and not approve this on the basis of their not doing an EIR and having virtually no public outreach. I mean, they conducted just one outreach meeting, and that was over 2 years ago. So how, and they've been virtually neglectful in involving the community in the planning or inviting us in to give us our suggestions for how they could use this site. So I urge you to keep up the struggle and show up and don't be discouraged.
So I hear there was a little protest this morning at 6 in the morning. Come here. You know what? Was it six in the morning? 6 a.m. So, you know, Casa Justa, which is our partner in crime here. I mean, you know what? We don't get out the way, right?
Yeah.
And, man, I just want you to come tell us. Come tell us what y'all did this morning.
All right.
Woohoo! How are we doing? I'm sorry, I will be a little slow. I woke up at 4 in the morning today so that we could be in San Francisco in the financial district at 6 a.m. in community labor solidarity. So we were out there as part of the Fight for 15 National Day of Action. Today, board notices, right? So imagine you own a franchise, you own a McDonald's somewhere, and all of a sudden a union rep comes up to you and goes, we are striking on this site and incites all throughout the Bay Area because you are not actually ensuring the $15 and the union promise
all right.
In San Francisco. San Francisco is a union town, and that means that that those are unions for public sector workers. Those are unions for folks that build our houses. And that also means unions for the people that take care of our kids, the people that work in our fast food restaurant service. Service industry folks also need a union. So we were out there as community folks because we understand that in San Francisco, unfortunately, we already have $15. How much is it doing for us?
Hopefully.
Is it enough? Is $15 enough in San Francisco? No. That's why in San Francisco and in the greater Bay Area, we understand that we need $15 in a union and access to dignified and affordable housing.
Yes.
Right? So it needs to be all three of those combined. And that is the message that we said loud and clear this morning throughout the financial district. We woke up the bosses, right? When we think about where the bosses are, when we think about Wall Street West, we were there, 6 a.m., waking people up. And then we stopped at Lennar. We stopped at their building. Brothers and sisters, our labor compañeros and compañeras understand that if the Mission has a fight against Lennar, if the Bayview Hunters Point has a fight against Lennar, if Treasure Island has a fight against Lennar, then labor has a fight against Lennar.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about.
And so we were there at 6 in the morning with 100, 200 of our closest friends, and we dropped some banners and let Lennar know that they do not have a place in the Mission. We fight gentrification, we stop Lennar. We want Lennar out of San Francisco altogether, but we definitely want them out of the Mission. We want to keep our cultural integrity intact, and that means that the mess on South Venice is not going to happen.
Right.
So, hopefully you see it on the news this morning. It's part of the National Day of Action for Fight, and we know affordable housing needs to be what gets prioritized, what gets built. We don't need any more market rate housing. We've had enough.
Last Thursday, and this was not unfortunate, but last Thursday night at Buena Vista Horse Fest, we had planned many weeks prior to that. Press conference at 11 o'clock in the morning, black and brown, calling for Kamala Harris, the Attorney General, to come down and do an independent study, investigation of all the murders that the San Francisco Police Department is conducting. And then, guess what? They already knew we were planning this press conference yesterday at 11 o'clock. And what did the chief of police do? Scheduled a community meeting to deal with the murder at 12 noon, knowing that people were going to be at City Hall at 11 o'clock, knowing that people from this community are working during the day and can't get on. But we organized very fast and very swiftly, and we packed the room yesterday.
Yeah! Woo!
We just let them get away with that shit. And I want to thank Supervisor Campos because one of the very few times that I see him get mad, I don't know if you saw the video, but Supervisor Campos got mad. He got angry, and he took on the chief because he didn't even have the decency and the respect to call Supervisor Campos to let him know that he was having this community meeting yesterday at 12 noon, and Supervisor Campos also called him out. How dare him call for and make statements to the press hinting and basically stating that it was okay for the police to kill this brother, you know? And that's exactly what is going on in this city. And where was Mayor Lee yesterday?
In Israel.
He goes to Brazil? No, I know that. He went to Israel, but he went to Brazil. And he went to Panama. And if you find out what what he's doing and you find out who he's traveling with, you're going to find out that he's selling once again our city for foreign investors to come here. Because if you track the money of Lennar, the money is foreign investors. You know? And so we get educated. We learn, we investigate, we research, we get the data, we get the facts. So please make sure that after today, you share with people what you learned today. It's very, very important that we have these dinner conversations. We have these conversations with our neighbors. We have conversations with people that we know live here so that they can get up and rise up. So, why is it important that these small actions like today? So the last time we were here, right, we called out Lennar because he only had one community meeting, which hardly anybody knew, which they kept a secret. He, and it's already been said, he's had no follow-up meetings with his community, okay? But what did we? What have we done? We went and we demanded that they not be on the calendar this week, this month, on April 21st. Supervisor Campos put in a call to the director of the planning department. The director of the planning department has been bombarded with emails and phone calls from a whole lot of us. And now the director of the planning department is asking the planning commission to postpone hearing this item on April 21st. You see what happens when we stand up and speak up? So, we need to show up on April 21st to make sure that the planning commissioners postpone that item, okay? And that will give us time, just like we did with the beach. We had that pulled off the calendar and had it postponed. I want to let you know that I was in a meeting with the Mayor's Office of Housing.
Really?
Yes, and we asked about the Lennar project because we first talked about having Lennar sell this property to the city.
Yeah.
And we asked the city to do that. And, you know, we're getting our ways with the city, little by little, one thing at a time. The city met with Lennar, and Lennar had the audacity, the nerve to say, we'll sell it to you for $40 million.
Thank you, Roberto. Thank you for leading us on to this charge. I just wanted to invite another resident who lives in the area who wants to talk about a little bit about Lennar. This is Tom Soprano.
Hi, everybody. Thanks so much for being here.
Press
the button.
All right. Oh, there we go. There's a little bit more juice. Thanks so much for being here. I actually live on this block right here, which would be in the shadow of this egregious luxury development that they're proposing for my corner. So let me tell you a bit about what is happening right here on this corner. I've lived here for 6 years, and every single day I see more and more of our homeless San Franciscans being forced to find shelter right here on the corner of 26 and South Van Ness. If we're building housing on this corner right here on 26 and South Van Ness, we need to be building housing for people like my neighbors who have no place to sleep but in the doorways of our neighborhoods here in the Mission. That's the only kind of housing we need to see right here on this corner. It's housing for the people who have no other roofs over their head and place to be. So as a resident here, thank you for standing with us. I spend a lot of time talking to my neighbors on this block. There's not a single person who thinks putting a bunch of luxury units on our corner is going to make our lives better or is going to do a damn thing to deal with the affordability crisis that we're facing in this neighborhood and in this city. So thanks for being here with us today.
So we have a responsibility. And that responsibility is to speak, to share what we talked about today. Because this brother that got killed last Thursday, you know, he lived on South Van Ness.
Yes.
He got evicted.
That's right.
And that's what happens. When you get evicted, you become homeless.
Yeah.
And he landed up living in the streets. A brother that was married, had children, and now his wife is a widow. His children are left without a father. You know? And so, homeless. What does Mayor Ed Lee have to say? Oh, let's get rid of these tents. That's his solution? Really? Really? Let's get rid of the tents? That's what his statement was after this killing last week. That is criminal.
Heartless.
Ed Lee, really? A man who at one time stood up against the I Hotel? What has happened to Ed Lee?
He's been told
and he's been poisoned.
Yeah.
Poisoned. Ed Lee has been poisoned. He needs a cleansing. Ay, cleansing, una limpieza necesita. Es el alcalde de San Francisco, una limpieza. Vamos a llamar a los santeros que lo vengan a hacerle con un pollo que lo limpien. So it is. It's important, and let's just end today with my cousin Travis Tatas clap, and we'll do the si se puede.
Time yet, but we will be getting it out to you by email, Facebook, however way we can, flyers, word of mouth. But the reason that Lennar wants to hear it, have the planning commission hear their request on April 21st is because they want to get it in before the June election, which is we're going to be voting on Proposition C, which is going to require developers to increase the inclusionary housing to 25%. So they want to get this in by the 21st so they don't have to meet those requirements.
Right.
So thank you for being here, and hope to see you on the 21st. Thank you.
I love our announcement. Tomorrow is Friday, April 15th, 4:15. What is our area code? 415. Tomorrow we're taking over Dolores Park at 4:15 in the afternoon.
At 4:20?
Join us tomorrow at Dolores Park.
Where is the park? The whole park. The whole park.
By the bell. 4:15 tomorrow at Dolores Park. Yeah, now you know I'd have to tell you what's going on, been going on at Dolores Park, right?
Yeah.
So that's why we got to reclaim Dolores Park tomorrow.
Yeah.